Hi, this is Tracy HD, and I want to thank you for joining me today for our daily energy and guidance reading. And I will be using the Work Your Light Oracle cards by Rebecca Campbell. You can use this as a three-card spread. Pick a card, one, two, or three, or a blended reading with all three cards combined. And today is February 20th. However, I consider this a timeless reading. Whenever it reaches you is when you're meant to receive the message. As I shuffle the deck, I'm asking all light beings, angels, and God, please relay the message I need to share with my viewers, the highest good of all. And I'll take this card for the first card. And then for card two, I'll take a card from the center. And the third card, I'll take the card from the bottom. Okay, the first card is Pleiades. Double mission, channeling and uplifting humanity. And what an interesting card that is. We have these people floating above. Okay, we have the beautiful stars and the galaxy and all of the beautiful colors in the background. And let me take a look at what the book says about this card here. This is only the third time I'm using this deck. I've decided to start using it because I really connected with the cards yesterday. So I'm going to be using this for our reading for quite a while, at least until we get to see almost all of the cards. Okay, and I wish these cards were numbered because they're kind of hard to find in the book. So if you'll just bear with me, let me just pull up the actual description of the card. Okay, here we go. And it reads, the Pleiadians are a group of star beings dedicated to raising the vibration of the planet and sharing new consciousness through creations and technology. They have been incarnating on Earth since near the beginning of humanity. You are a soul who has a double mission to grow at soul level and to raise the vibration of the planet. If you have been called to write, speak, or channel, this is your sign to keep doing it. Your work is divinely guided. Of all the souls, Palladians are the chattiest, and so perhaps you have already started channeling some of this work into the third dimension. Thank you for doing your part in the great plan. Your presence and unique light is needed. So, wow, very, very interesting. I mean, I'm a Gemini, so you can't get a chattier sign than Geminis. We love to communicate. And like I've been mentioning in my videos, I've been anxious to write my book. And a few of the readings I've done for myself said something is going to begin for me in the spring, and I have a feeling it may be just that. What a beautiful message for card one. And then card two is Anna, grandmother of Jesus. And I love the beautiful pastel colors, the pink and the blue and the greens. And there's this village and these beautiful rose details. I love roses, like the roses on the back of the card. I just love them. They're just so beautiful. There's such feminine energy to them. And this says, seeding the light, laying foundations, divine plan. So let's take a look at what this has to say in the book as well, because these meanings are just so deep and so interesting. And like I said, the cards are absolutely gorgeous. I hope the camera is picking up on the beauty of this card. It says, Anna, grandmother of Jesus, was an ancient mystic who dedicated her life to laying the foundation for Christ consciousness to be woven through all of life. She is not widely known, but without her, Christ consciousness would not be rising as it is today. Anna represents the quiet dedication that is sometimes required to live a life of service. She represents the generations that came before that devoted their lives to dreaming a new world into being while knowing that they would not see the glorious end result. She represents the dutiful soldier, the unconditional mother, and the mystic who can see the thread that is woven through all of life. Anna teaches us that We all have a part to play in the divine plan. It doesn't have to be on the world stage to be significant. One person's part is not worthier than another. One person's part may be to mother their children. Another may be to gather women in a circle each month. No part is better or worse, more important or less significant. We each have within us a seed of light that we incarnated to share and is gathering us to remember and surrender to our part of the plan. So, yes, we all have a plan. Like she said, maybe it's being a mother to your children. If you don't have children, maybe you're meant to speak on a larger level to people gathering around, like she's gathering people around and sharing experiences and motivating people and healing people. Everything is according to the divine plan. What a beautiful message for that card. And then the last card is, fill up your well. And how gorgeous is this? She's surrounded by the water. She has her eyes closed. It's such a peaceful, peaceful energy to this card. We have the moon in the background. Of course, we have the beautiful roses. And it looks like we have some cactus here. Although we do have the water here and a cactus there. What do they call that? An oasis where there's water, where there is desert. It's so beautiful. And the blue is just so calming in this card. And it says retreat, rest, and refuel. And of course, we don't have to go to the book for this. This is another repeat message from yesterday's reading. I believe card number 2 was a card talking about resting and recharging. And it is so important that we do because we're going through so much. Okay, so many challenges, so many changes. I mean, it is exhausting. We need to be rested and recharged and refueled in order to be alert and alive and to be able to pick up on the signs and the synchronicities. When we're exhausted and rushing around and tired and worn out, we're not able to hear our gut feelings or feel our intuition. So it is just so important that since we're going through such a dramatic transformation, each and every one of us, I mean, we may be on different levels of our spiritual paths, but none is less important than the other. And we need to make sure we're taking care of our bodies. And I've never been more aware of this than I have been since last year and the beginning of this year. I mean, I hate to bring it up again, but last year was one of the most exhausting years of my entire life. And I believe it was the clearing away of all of the negative and toxic things and people that just had to go. And believe me, I'm still recovering from it and I'm not pushing myself. I'm so used to overworking myself to the point of exhaustion where that is a bad habit and I need to change that. And a lot of you out there watching this video are the same way. You have children to take care of, maybe a household to take care of. Some of you are going to work as well as doing all those things. I mean, there's just so much. You really just have to slow down and prioritize what you can do today and what needs to wait until tomorrow because it doesn't have to all get done in one day. And that is a lesson that I've had to learn myself. And this card is reminding us that it is so important to retreat and rest. Even if you could just sit quietly every once in a while throughout your day, whether at work, at your desk, or at home with your children, or just outside in nature, you know, do a few breathing exercises, breathing in and breathing out. And how I do it is I breathe out negativity and I breathe in positive vibes. I'm releasing negative energy and I'm breathing in positive energy. And I say this in my mind as I'm inhaling and exhaling. And believe me, just 5 minutes of that will ground you. It will clear your head and it will give you that tiny little break that you need. You know, during your day when things seem to be getting hectic and out of control, you just catch yourself when things start, you know, producing anxiety. And you're going to be so much happier at the end of the day. You're going to feel like you have so much more energy than if you just kept pushing yourself nonstop all day. So do something to rest and recharge and refuel. And be sure that you're eating healthy and getting enough water. It is so important to hydrate as well. So rest, hydrate, try to eat healthy foods, and do a little bit of going within with those breathing exercises. And believe me, you will start to feel so much more positive. Your vibration will be so much more positive. You feel so much more of a lightness. Beautiful reading today. If you've enjoyed this reading, please like it by giving it a thumbs up, share it above all, and subscribe because I will be back with more.